Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. I am a big fan of artist John McNaughton and have been from the beginning. I think everyone should own one or more of his prints. He's got incredible talent. Not only that, but he has an uncanny way of looking into the hearts and minds of Americans and then painting what they really feel. His paintings are moving and patriotic, and he's a big fan of President Trump. What's not to love? I urge you to look at his paintings. You will love him the way I do, I'm sure of it. He's famous in conservative circles and is not only a talented artist, he's got a sharp wit to go with it, and he is an intellectual as well. Facebook does not share my admiration of John McNaughton, evidently. An ad for his latest painting that depicts President Trump crossing the swamp, reminiscent of the famous painting, Washington Crossing the Delaware, was not accepted on Facebook. McNaughton's site describes his painting as follows: "Over 240 years ago, George Washington suffered through Valley Forge and crossed the Delaware River to bring an astonishing victory to the Continental Army. This led to what many thought was impossible, to defeat a despot king and his formidable army. Today, Trump endeavors to cross the swamp of Washington, D.C. as he carries the light of truth, hope, and prosperity. The murky water of the deep state is laced with dangerous vermin, perfectly willing to destroy American prosperity for their personal ideologies and financial gain. The establishment Democrats, never Trumper Republicans, deep state, and fake news media will do all they can to stop the majority of the American people from succeeding." Trending: judge has had it with Mueller team, abruptly ends court after their humiliating screw-up. "As an artist, I paint what I feel needs to be said about the current state of our country. My hope is that Trump will be remembered as the president that restored America's greatness. I want to be on that boat for freedom. Crossing the swamp, never give up. Never lower your light. Never stop till the swamp is dry. John McNaughton." I can't believe my Facebook advertisement was rejected. See the painting at https://t.co/lrt1pnwmsqpic.twitter.com/zvn68ls7ow. John McNaughton, at McNaughton R. August 3, 2018. What was the problem? You were advertising your art. Do Facebook advertising policies prohibit advertising artwork? Selena, at Selena Keffer, August 3, 2018. Censoring free speech. What else is new? TJ Heck, at RealTJek, August 3, 2018. The left immediately ridiculed the painting online. For those of us who are constitutionalists, though, it has a significant and poignant meaning. In the boat are members of President Trump's cabinet. Trump is standing and leading the way. Passengers in the boat include Nikki Haley, James Mattis, Ben Carson, President Trump, Jeff Sessions, Mike Pence, Melania Trump, Mike Pompeo, Sarah Sanders, Ivanka Trump, John Bolton, Kellyanne Conway, and John Kelly. I think it is certainly representative of Trump's fight against the deep state and his efforts to drain the swamp. It also pays homage to those who are fighting alongside him. McNaughton submitted his ad to Facebook to promote his painting, never dreaming it would be rejected. He tweeted out a screenshot of the rejection with a red circle around the rebuff from Facebook. "John's paintings have stirred controversy from the beginning and are a lightning rod for derision from the left. They depict current political events as he sees them. Facebook did not give a reason for the rejection, and Patriots demand to know why they saw fit to nix McNaughton's ad. Facebook runs ads for leftist groups all over the place, including Media Matters, Planned Parenthood, and a bevy of other radical leftist institutions. There is nothing wrong with this painting unless, of course, you hate President Trump. Then there is plenty to not like, I guess. I simply don't get why Facebook would reject John's ad here. It makes no sane sense." If you will remember, Sean Hannity gave President Trump McNaughton's The Forgotten Man as a present immediately after his inauguration. It is a unique painting as well, and McNaughton describes it this way: "Against the background of a darkening sky, all of the past presidents of the United States gather before the White House, as if to commemorate some great event. In the left-hand corner of the painting sits a man. That man, with his head bowed, appears distraught and hopeless as he contemplates his future. Some of the past presidents try to console him while looking in the direction of the modern presidents as if to say, 'What have you done?' Many of these modern presidents, seemingly oblivious to anything other than themselves, appear to be congratulating each other on the great accomplishments. In front of the man, paper trash is blowing in the wind. Crumpled dollar bills, legislative documents, and, like a whisper, the US Constitution beneath the foot of Barack Obama. John McNaughton does not sell his original paintings. But in the case of The Forgotten Man, he made an exception. He sold the painting to Sean Hannity, who in turn gifted it to Trump. The title is in reference to The Forgotten Man, A New History of the Great Depression, by Amity Schles. It's a reanalysis of the events of the Great Depression, generally from a free market perspective. It was a heartfelt and apropos gift to President Trump. Crossing the Swamp has even more feeling and patriotism in it, if that is possible. Facebook needs to explain themselves on this. America is waiting. Note from the editor, the views and opinions expressed in this article are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the position of this website or of the owners, administrators of where this article is shared online. Claims are made in this piece are based on the author's own opinion and not stated as evidence of fact.